The health department warns Filipinos against nasal swabs on themselves. Health Secretary Francisco Duque says these may produce unreliable results since they're being done without the help of medical professionals. The warning follows a viral video of Filipino actor Robin Padilla, who collected his own sample for COVID testing.
Meron tayong mga panuntunan o pamantayan para gawin yan. Hindi pwedeng sarili mong gagawin yan dahil unang-una ang iyong resulta ay magiging questionable dahil kung hindi naman ito na ayon sa mga tamang pamantayan, eh kaduda-duda magiging resulta. So hindi po natin dapat ginagawa ito.
Padilla reasoned he was already accustomed to getting poked up the nose 3 times a week. He added, it just so happened no health workers were around to conduct the procedure.
The Interior Department gives its assurance due process will be followed in the arrest of village leaders who failed to prevent health protocol violations in their jurisdictions.
Joyce Balanstro also tells us the Justice Department is now studying the legal basis for the President's latest directive.
President Rodrigo Duterte has had enough following incidents of mass gatherings in Caloocan City, Bulacan and Quezon City at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic. The chief executive now wants stiffer penalties against local community leaders who violate the ban on public gatherings amid repeated warnings these can turn into super spreader events.
Pag may isang one single incident beginning tonight, the police will just arrest the barangay captain first and bring him to the station together with the yung nagpipiknik dyan, ang maaristo, silang lahat, have them investigated. The police are put on notice that they are supposed to arrest. It's a valid one. Huwag kayong matakot na mag-aristo ng barangay captain.
He said village officials can be liable for dereliction of duty. And it's not just officials. The president also want health protocol violators to face charges.
I will look for a suitable law because you are now forcing my hand to get into this thing and control it.
For Chief Presidential Legal Counsel Salvador Panelo, violators can be liable for reckless imprudence. One official who could face possible charges is Alan Franza, the village chairman of Matandang Balara in Quezon City, which has one of the highest COVID-19 cases in the National Capital Region. Franza says he's ready to be arrested after residents crowded an aid distribution event on May 25. But there's a catch.
Kung ipapakulong po ako, nakahanda po akong magpakulong. Basta kasama yung konsehal, si Konsehal Franz Pumari, na nag-organisa nung pantry na yun.
They still have to conduct investigation. Yung sa akin was not a social event. It was not a recreational event. It was not a sports event. This is an ayuda.
In Bulacan, the provincial police office will indict over 25 local executives from Barangay Matiktik in Norzagaray after allowing tourists to swim in Bacas River without following health protocols.
Supposedly, di ba, meron tayong mga health protocols na maglalagbook ka para sa contact tracing, lalagay mo saan ka nakatira, anong pangalan mo. Mukhang nakalimutan na nila lahat yun o kinalimutan na nila pag nakakita na sila ng 20 pesos.
Interior Secretary Eduardo Anyo said, policemen led by the Joint Task Force COVID-19 Shield are tasked to do the arrests. Local community leaders can be detained for 12 hours and preventively suspended while an investigation is ongoing. Secretary Anyo notes, due process will be followed.
Hindi ba sabihin na automatic, no? Binibigyan natin ng pagkakataon sa kapitan na gawin ang lahat ng paukulang aksyon para matigil, ma-prevent, maiwasan yung mga super spreader event. Pero despite of that, nakita natin, walang ginagawa si kapitan. Ay doon talaga papasok ang sinasabi ng Pangulo na arestuhin mo na yan.
The Department of Justice says it will study the legal basis of Duterte's orders and if health protocol violators can be charged with reckless imprudence. Justice Undersecretary Adrian Sugay also explained that under Philippine laws, only a judge can issue an arrest warrant, but there can be warrantless arrests and caught-in-the-act cases. Sugay adds local ordinances in each city or municipality can be enough basis to penalize those violating the ban on mass gatherings. The DOJ and the DILG are finalizing a joint memorandum circular that will set clearer guidelines on violations of health protocols. The Commission on Human Rights, for its part, reminds government that if arrests against violators will push through, rule of law should be followed and human rights should be respected at all times. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.